नमस्कार टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स. माय सेल्फ वीवीएन साक्षी पांडे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक एंड फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंसेस. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल बेसिकली टॉक अबाउट द फॉलिक एसिड. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द विटामिन. लेट्स टेक अ ग्लांस एट दैट. विटामिन, एज यू ऑल नो, विटामिंस आर द बेसिक सोर्सेज और बेसिक न्यूट्रिएंट व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द living beings. It is comes under the class of micronutrient. Micronutrient, what are micronutrients? Which is required in many minute amount, but to fulfill the basic function of the human life. So those are micronutrients. In micronutrient, basically what comes here, vitamins and minerals. So both of these nutrients required in many minute amount, like in mg or mu g, but it contain very vital function of a human body. So in this class we will discuss about the folic acid, also known as vitamin B9, and this vitamin is belong to the class of water soluble vitamin. Okay, so water soluble vitamin, what are they? They are basically soluble in water, not soluble in fat, but they are only soluble in water. Thus it makes them excrete out in your urine, means its absorption cannot take place in your body. Okay, so as they are water soluble, they can be easily excreted out from the body, hence their absorption cannot take place in the body. Okay, so folic acid is one of the water soluble vitamins. So the folic acid is basically derived from the Latin word which means folum, which means leaf. Okay, so it is isolated from the leafy green vegetable, that is your spinach. Okay, so it is firstly given, the scientists have excreted or isolated the folic acid from spinach, and it means derived from the Latin word folium, which means the leaf. Okay, so folic acid is mainly consist of three compounds. As we go glance to the folic acid, first you should know about the introductory part of folic acid. So it basically consists of three compounds. Okay, first is your tyrosine ring, second is your aminobenzoic acid, third is your glutamic acid residue. Okay, hence it is also known as pterol glutamic acid. Okay, so this is also the common name of folic acid because of the composition of it. Okay, now if we talk about the active form, so as you have known that all the water soluble vitamin involves in their active form, also known as coenzyme form. It cannot work or cannot function by their own. It requires some sort of coenzymes to perform their function. Okay, so folic acid is one of them. So folic acid, the active form of folic acid or the coenzyme of folic acid is your THF, that is tetrahydrofolate, also known as FH4. It is the active form of folic acid. So this is tetrahydrofolate. What they contain? They contain the three main related compound of folic acid, that is tyrosine ring, para aminobenzoic acid and glutamic acid. Okay, in this glutamic acid is your acidic amino acid, benzoic acid, aminobenzoic acid ring is present, and also with tyrosine ring. Okay, so this is the active form of folic acid. So folic acid, how this active form is basically arises, like when you take folic acid in your diet. Okay, like when you take any folic acid rich food, then the folic acid that you have taken from a good amount of sources, then this that folic acid is basically catabolized by the enzyme, that is dehydrofolate reductase. Okay, so what this enzyme do? This enzyme is basically catabolized, or this enzyme is basically what divide folic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid, that is its active form, that is THF. Okay, now we'll discuss about the metabolism of folic acid. So metabolism, when we talk about the metabolism, it generally occur in some phases. The very first phase of metabolism is your absorption. Okay, so absorption, what happened? Absorption of folic acid is not absorbed by the intestine. It is not absorbed by your intestine. But what happens? Like once the folic acid molecule is exists as a polyglutamate with 3 to 7 glutamate residues, and this glutamate side chain are cleaved by the enzyme folate conjugase and polyglutamate hydrolase. Okay. So what they do, they form a monoglutamic form, and this is the only form which is absorbed in the intestine. Okay, so you have understood, like folic acid is basically doesn't absorb as it is purest form. It has to be converted into monoglutamic form, then only it can be absorbed in your intestine. Okay, the enzyme folate conjugase is present in your duodenum and jejunum, which is the part of your small intestine. Okay, so this is how the absorption is done. The second phase of metabolism is your storage. Okay, so storage, what happens? Like when we talk about the storage, so inside the cell. Okay, so it's basically stored inside the cell, liver cell, that is also known as your Kupffer cell. Okay, so the polyglutamate form is a storage form of folic acid, which is basically stored in your liver cells. Okay, so this is all about the metabolism of folic acid. Okay, now we will talk about like what are the richest sources of folic acid. So when we talk about the dietary sources, so you may have heard about folic acid is very much in rich in your green leafy vegetables. Okay, such as spinach, cauliflower, kale, okay, and your batwa. This is all the greatest and richest source of folic acid. And when we talk about the non-vegetarian sources or the animal sources, so it's basically considered as the poor sources of folic acid. Hence, folic acid is widely distributed in your plant source. Okay. Now, the RDA of folic acid. So, RDA is what your recommended dietary allowances. Okay, so as a student of nutrition, you should know about the RDA of particular nutrient. So, folic acid is very, very important nutrient which is required for every and each age group. And RDA is generally what recommend dietary allowances according to the particular age group. Okay, so when we talk about men, adult man, that is your 20 plus of male, it should they should require 100 mg per day of folic acid. Okay, and woman, adult woman is basically required 100 mg of mg per day of folic acid. And when we talk about pregnancy and lactation, so folic acid is very much essential for the pregnant women. If folic acid is not there in pregnancy, so it can lead to many neurological disorder in fetus. Okay, many sort of your spinal cord disorder. So folic acid is very essential for in pregnancy period. For about 400 mg per day is required for pregnant ladies. For lactation ladies, it is required 100 mg per day. Okay, so this is what your folic acid. Now we will talk about the deficiency, which is basically occur by the folic acid. So dietary deficiency, the major causes of dietary deficiency is inadequate intake. When you do not consume enough amount of green leafy vegetable, then it can lead to dietary deficiency. Overcooking of some food, okay, when you overcook food, when you give overheating to the food or you reheat the food, the content of folic acid is basically lost or reduced. Okay. The third cause can be the impaired absorption. Impaired absorption is what? When your intestine is not able to absorb that folic acid in a proper way. Okay, like you have consuming a very good amount of folic acid, for example, but it is not absorbed by your intestine due to some sort of impaired absorption, or you may say any sort of intestinal disorder or diseases. Okay, and the fourth causes is your drug interference. Like for the particular, if you're taking some sort of drugs, okay, some sort of disorder drugs like blood pressure doses or any sort of diabetes. Okay, so in that cases, that drug that is particularly hinder the folic acid absorption. Increased demand can also be leads to the deficiency disorder, like when your demand is increases but you are not taking in a very good amount, then it can also lead to the what your deficiency. So the most common deficiency which is seen in folic acid is your hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia, what is it? It is what when the folic acid is not impaired amount in your body, and it can lead to your heme like what is heme? It is a part of your hemoglobin, and when your heme is lytic means when it is breakdown. Okay, so what happened here? Your RBC breakdown is generally seen, and your patient is not able to produce enough amount of blood to supply the oxygen. Okay, so this is what is hemolytic anemia. Its clinical features can be megaloblastic anemia, characterized by hypochromic microlytic anemia due to maturation, and megaloblastic can be seen in bone marrow and mucosa. Patients generally look very pale in this phase. The blood is very lost. Okay, so the patient's skin became very very white and very pale. Gliotosis is one of the symptoms which is seen in here. What happened in this? The ulceration is basically seen in the mouth area, okay, and the lips became the crack. So this is what happened when we do not take enough amount of what? Folic acid. When we talk about in pregnant lady, when a pregnant lady is deficient in folic acid, what happened to the fetus? The fetus is became the bone marrow fetus generally not able to develop properly. This shows the abnormal large size of cells and cytoplasmic maturation, but impaired nuclear maturation due to defective DNA synthesis. And this produced the red blood cell production very improper way. Okay, so this is what happened in your folic acid deficiency. It can be found, it can be assessed, like how can you assess whether the person is folic acid deficient or not? There are several tests. Like for example, low plasma folic acid level, low red cell folic acid level, B12 level, increased plasma LDH level. Okay, so these all are the findings. So from low plasma folic acid level, you can basically see when your folic acid level is less than 3 mg per ml, then it leads to low plasma folic acid level, which consider as patient is deficient in what? Folic acid. Okay, and when the red blood cell folic acid level became reduced up to 150 mg per ml, then it also indicates a person is very much deficient in folic acid. Okay, so these are the biochemical findings. And for this, we can do some sort of test like Figlu test. Figlu test is associated with the folic acid deficiency test. It is also known as for amino glutamate test, and it is done in from the urine sample. Okay, and this test is for the assessment of neural tube defect also. Neural tube defect is basically what happened when the pregnant lady is not able to satisfy their folic acid requirement. Okay, so folic acid supplement during pregnancy helps to prevent the neural tube defect. It mainly involves brain and spinal cord. Okay, so if any lady or any fetus is suffering from neural tube defect, its spinal cord and its brain doesn't properly develop, which can lead to mental retardation and also impair the neural development of the fetus. Okay, so this is all what is associated with your folic acid disorder. Okay, so I hope you are well satisfied with this session. So for your competitive exam, you can learn about the RDA level of folic acid, like the RDA requirement for the folic acid, and the types of neural tube defect, which is generally happens for the pregnant lady. Okay, so thank you all for the session.